Amen, brothers, sisters, and friends. Welcome back to church. Glad to see all of you. Okay, you see this sign? Let's switch our phones, mobile devices into silent mode, airplane mode. And let's all rise and sing song to God. 弟兄姐妹朋友们，很开心看到大家。哦，你刚刚你们看到那个标志，表示我们要把我们的手机，哦，行动装置调成静音啊。然后一起站起来，来敬拜我们的神。
Oh, eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let's bow down our head for our opening prayer. Heavenly God, Father, thank you for this wonderful Sunday that you gathered us here to pray to you, God, as a church. We thank you for your faithfulness in our lives. It is because of your loving kindness and care, protection, that we are here today, God. I thank you for gathering us today for this wonderful service, praising you with songs and prayer, God. We call on to you to guide us through this Sunday service with our worship and praises. Thank you, for God, for your forgiveness to our sins so that we are acceptable before your presence, God. Please allow your Holy Spirit to be in our midst. As we start this service, may you to be glorified from the beginning to the end. Please give us your peace and open our hearts, so that we be able to listen to your words when later our brother shares your word to us. And I pass all things in your hand. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thanks, Joshua, for leading us into the awesome prayer. One more song.
Sometimes I can feel alone. little shy. Is that I need to know that you are there, that's why
I'm singing.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm down.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm lonely.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm tired.
Be with me,
meet you only.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm down.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm lonely.
Be with me, Lord,
when I need you, Lord.
Be with me. I know you said that I would not be tested, or that I could bear. And then you have my best in mind with everything that ever comes my way. I know you're in control, so hear me as I pray.
I'm singing, be with me, Lord,
when I'm down.
Be with me, Lord, when I'm lonely.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm tired.
Be with me,
need you only.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm down.
Be with me,
when I'm lonely,
be with me, Lord,
when I need your Lord,
be with me, be my only God.
Now help me, Lord,
just share what I've been given. Help me make a difference with the life I'm living. As I show my neighbor a true treasure store, help me know you promise to be with me, Lord.
I'm singing,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm down.
When I'm lonely,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm tired,
be with me,
need you only,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm down,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm lonely,
be with me, Lord,
when I need you,
be
Lord,
be with me, be my only God,
be with me,
be my only God.
I'm singing,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm down,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm lonely,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm tired.
Need you
only,
be with me, Lord,
when I'm down.
Be with me, Lord,
when I'm lonely.
Be with me, Lord,
when I need you, Lord.
Be my only God.
Be with me,
be my only God.
Be with me, be my only God.
Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Good afternoon, everyone. Very good to see all of you.
Hello, 大家午安，看见大家真的是很好。
And I'm excited to be able to share today on our new series.
我非常的兴奋，今天可以跟大家分享一个新的系列。
Okay, from the book of John.
它是取自于约翰福音。
So we already finished Luke. I hope you have a great time studying the book of Luke.
这时刻呢，我们其实已经读完了路加福音。我希望大家也已经完成了。
So for John, I already sent out the Quiet Time series to your leaders. Make sure you get a copy.
那这一个新的系列呢，我已经是把那个灵修已经是分发给你们的领袖了，请跟他们拿。
So the book of Luke, the theme. Okay, let's go to the introduction. Let's go to the introduction on the gospel of the book of Luke.
我们来看一看
John.
约翰福音的简介。
All right, John is a great book, one of my favorite book.
它是我其中一个非常喜欢的一本书。
So if you study John, you'll find that it's very different from the three other gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke.
比起另外三本福音书呢，约翰福音是很特别的。
Okay, John, is written from a very personal and intimate point of view.
因为呢，他是这个作者呢，是从一个非常私人的角度上去写这本书。
You really get to know Jesus deep, okay, deeply in the heart.
那呢，从这一本福音里，你能够体会深入的体会到谁是真正的耶稣。
You get to really hear his voice, understand his emotion.
因为呢，你可以从中感受得到耶稣他真正的情绪，和他的感受是什么。
So John is written by the Apostle John. He has a brother named James. is one of they are part of the 12 apostles.
那作者是使徒约翰，他也有一个兄弟是叫雅各。
All right, Jesus called them sons of thunder.
那耶稣呢叫使徒约翰为雷霆之子啊。
All right, so if you study the gospel, you know why? Because they seem to be very aggressive, you know, the more fierce or angry type.
那你如果读其他的福音书，你会发现说，使徒约翰是一个性格上非常就是刚烈的一个人。
And you know, once they went into a town, and the town was not willing to accept Jesus.
那就讲到其中一个故事，说他们去到了一个城，个小城那些人不。那么的接受他们
，so they say, Jesus, shall we call down thunder, again lightning to strike this town?
然后呢，使徒约翰就跟耶稣说他，说主啊，你要不要在天上叫雷，然后跟他打，然后把整个城市给
？Of course, you know Jesus rebuked them, yeah.
当然，我们也知道说耶稣的反应之后是怎么样的，耶稣是把责备了他。
So you can see, you know, John, his demeanor, he's not a peaceful guy, you know, he's not somebody who is very, yeah, he's just, don't get in a fight with him.
简单来说呢，你不好招惹使徒约翰这种人，也不简单了。
All right, but yet, you know, even though he's rough, he's tough, very aggressive kind of guy, you know, Jesus, even he called himself, again, as a disciple that Jesus loved.
可是呢，虽然使徒约翰有这种那么特别的性格，但是不管如此呢，耶稣还是称他为耶稣心爱的门徒。
So you can get the contrast, right? The sense, you know, tough guy, rough guy, you know, the gangsterism kind of a character. But yet at the same time, the tenderness, right, of Jesus.He felt the tenderness of Jesus.
你可以看见一个强烈的对比，关于到就是使徒约翰呢，他那种刚烈，而且已经到达几乎是流氓式的那种那种性格呢。可是呢，却因着耶稣那种对他那种亲切的爱呢，而受到耶稣的爱吸引。
So you know, can see how much Jesus love and accept all types of people.
也看到耶稣接受不管任何一种性格的人。
So in fact, the impact of Jesus' love was so great that when you read his other letters, 1 John, 2 John, 3 John,
那我们呢可以看见哦，耶稣在使徒约翰的身上所带来的那种影响力是来到，甚至当你看见使徒约翰之后，在写约翰一书、二书、三书的时候
，And you know it's all filled with the word love, right? You read First John, wow, love is everywhere. What happened to that guy who is like, let's send down thunder?
那你就发现说，在他的书，就是使徒约翰的书里面，他写的最多的是用爱怎样子。他就用了很多关于到爱的那种词语，然后你会讲说这个人怎么搞的，他变了，他以前不是像流氓这样，就变了什么样。
Okay, so you can see from a son of thunder to become a son of tenderness.
Tenderness 是温柔的，就是
很温柔
啊。然后从一个 you know, 刚烈 的性格，如何怎么可以变到一个温柔的一个人呢。
So the, you know, when you meet Jesus, when you encounter Jesus, your character will change, just like John.
也就是说呢，如果今天我们真正能够接触到耶稣的话呢，我们的性格也会像施洗约翰一样会改变的。
Again, that's the blessing, one of the blessing of following Jesus.
那就是跟随耶稣的其中一种祝福。
So the book of John was written probably around 90 AD or 90 CE. That means 90 years after the birth of Christ.
那约翰福音这本书呢，其实是在公元就是九十after
Christ.
After Christ 就是耶稣 出事后的那个九十年后
in the city of Ephesus，
在以弗所这个地方写。
Okay, it's the last book of the New Testament that was written.
那么呢，它是呢
New Testament.
新约的最后的一本书。
Well, not the last book. Revelation was the last book.
Yeah. Last gospel. 最后的一本福音书。Yeah.
Okay. And this is just before he was exiled into the, you know, John, a tremendous guy. He loved Jesus so much that he was willing to be exiled into the island of Patmos as a prisoner.
其实很感激，就是像是使约翰他的这种态度，他愿意为耶稣付出甚至被放逐到外岛，他都愿意这样做。
So John, the purpose of John was to declare the deity of Jesus as the Son of God. In other words, Jesus is divine, he's God.
那约翰福音这本书呢，主要的目的呢，是要证明耶稣他就是神。
Right, many times you know we ask, why do we want to follow Jesus? Why not another philosopher? Why not another religion?
你说我们会问为什么一定要跟随耶稣呢？为什么不要跟随另外一个可能哲学家，可能另外一个很有知识的啊？为什么只要跟随耶稣呢？
Because this is the reason. Because Jesus, he's God. He's not a man. He's not a philosopher. He's not a great teacher. He is God himself in human form.
这其实就是我们的答案。他因为他是神，而他不是一个哲学家，他也不是一个所谓好的老师，不是，而是他是神。
Okay, only he can forgive sin, and only he can have the authority to bring us to heaven.
也唯独只有耶稣，他有这一个权柄来去赦免我们的罪，也只有他可以带我们回到天国。
Okay, and so John wrote this book to help us to believe.Right, to help us to really believe and have that conviction that Jesus is the Son of God, and by believing, you will have life.
那使徒约翰呢写这本书的目的就是他要让我们去明白和有这个证明，去接受着耶稣他就是神，而且只有唯独从耶稣那里可以得到生命。
Because you find many of us, you know, even though we, you know, we go to church, we read the Bible, we follow Jesus, you know, sometimes we struggle, right? We see the world, we hear from outsiders, we struggle in our faith with Jesus.
这样的时候呢，我们生命里面，虽然我们来教会，但是呢，因着世界上所有的引诱啦，不同的说法啦，都影响到了我们对于耶稣我们主的那个信心。
So John doesn't want us to struggle. He wants us to believe. This is the way. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody goes to the Father except through him.
那约翰呢，他其实他的目的，他就是要写下这本福音书，他要叫我们知道说，唯独只有主耶稣基督呢，是生命真理和道路。
And of course, thus, you find the key word that is expressed over and over again in the book of John is what? The word believed. Do you believe? We have to believe. And by believing, you have life.
你看见约翰呢，他重复的在这本福音书里面继续不断提到的字眼是相信。你相信吗？你真的相信吗？重复的，再重复的。
Okay, and the team, by believing, we need to respond. All right, Jesus called Peter and all of us, go, feed the lamb. What does that mean? Take care of one another.
那去相信的意思呢，就是耶稣吩咐我们说，你若相信的话呢，你就要照顾我的羔羊。
All right, John, very interesting. He has, you know, there's a distinctive feature about the statement of who Jesus is.
约翰写这本福音书呢，他有特别的称耶稣的几种称呼。
Again, it's called the seven I am's of Jesus.
那可以称为说是四种可以称耶稣为谁啊？他是谁？自称是谁
？Correct. Okay, we're not going to go through this. All right, you can take a photo. You know, basically here when you know the seven I am, you get to really understand God's character more.
因为呢，当我们在看见使徒约翰写到耶稣自称自己是谁的时候呢，你会更加了解到耶稣的真正身份。
Right, he's the bread, he's the light, he's the gate, he's a good shepherd, he's the resurrection, he's the only resurrection, the truth, the life, the way, and the true vine.
那他耶稣的自称是说，耶稣说他是生命的粮，世界的光，羊的门，好牧人，他是我们的复活生命，然后他也是道路、真理和生命。然后他最后他说他是真葡萄树。
So in other words, you know, if you want to grow, you want to have life, you need to what? Depend on Jesus.
那换句话说是什么呢？就说如果我们今天要得到生命的话呢，我们需要依靠主耶稣。
We need Jesus. It's not Jesus needed, huh?
所以搞清楚，是我们需要依靠主耶稣，不是。
If you read further on John chapter 15, Jesus says, "I'm the vine. You know, I'm the branch. I'm the vine. You are the branches. You need me to grow. You need me to sustain your life."
那甚至呢，你在读到约翰福音第十五章那边提到，耶稣说他是真葡萄树，而我们只不过是他的枝干罢了。我们需要依靠在这棵真葡萄树上才可以活。
All right, so now we're gonna go into the study of John chapter 1.
所以我们来看第一章。
So it's about the presentation of the Son of God.
它是关于到人子的的意思。
All right, so let's read chapter 1, verse 1-5.
我们来读约翰福音第一章一到五节。太初有道，道与神同在，道就是神。这道太初与神同在，万有是借着他造的，凡被造的没有一样不是借着他造的。在他里面有生命，这生命就是人的光，光照在黑暗中，黑暗不能胜过光。
You know, you read this passage, it's kind of complicated.
我们读这段经文的时候有点复杂。
Right, in the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God, He was with God in the beginning. It's kind of like, what is He trying to say?
对，我们在读到他说，太初有道，道与神同在，道就是神，等等等等，然后觉得有一点。
Again, of course, we know that the Word is Jesus.
可是当然我们也知道说，那个道就是指的是耶稣。
And everything on this earth is made by Him.
然后呢，这世界上所有的都是神所造的。
Again, and in Him is the light, and light means what? The one that guide our lives, right? The light and the life.
甚至呢，他也形容到在耶稣里面有这个生命，也有那个光。光的意思是什么呢？就是那个指导的方向。
And in this verse 14, it talks about how Jesus, the Word.Right, God became flesh and lived among us.
之后呢，在读第十四节呢，他说道成了肉身，住在我们当中。
All right, so you know what's all this about?
那这一些经文都，就是在讲什么
？If you boil it down, it basically in chapter one, John wants you to understand that Jesus is the incarnation of the Son of God. In other words, Jesus.I mean, God, our God in heaven, came down on earth, took the form of a lowly human being.
那么，读了这两段经文呢，其实约翰要表达的就是，神呢，在天上的神呢，已经是成了肉身，然后之后活在我们当中。
And not only to become a human being, you know, if you read in Philippians chapter 2, verse 5 to 8.
那他不单单就是神天上高高在上的神成了我们人活在我们当中，甚至在腓立比书的第
chapter 2 verse 5 to 8
第二章第五到第八节。
It says that Jesus, right? Jesus became obedient even to death. That means he decided, an immortal being decided I'm willing to die.
那甚至那段经文提到耶稣他不单愿意成为肉身，甚至呢他愿意顺服直到他可以为我们而死。
And death on a cross, the worst way to die.
然后呢，而死在十字架上最残酷的死法。
You know, it's so complicated. Why would God become a man?
当然，为什么神需要成为肉身在活在我们当中？
Right, if it's us, if you're up there in heaven, you know, will you give up your place and say, I'm gonna give up my place and be a man?
如果今天换成你，你会愿意舍弃天上而来到世上做耶稣所做的这一切吗？
Again, you know, just now I was having some time with the campus brothers.
然后刚才呢，我就跟着这些在校园团契的弟兄姐妹。
Again, one of the brothers say, you know, becoming a Christian is like having two choices, two buttons.
其中一个弟兄他就分享说，他说当命基督徒就很像每一天需要就是去在我生命里面有两个按钮，每天就要做选择。
The first button is if you press it, you're gonna get ₱1 billion. 哇！
第一个
I want to press.
第一个按钮呢是，你只要一按下去的话，你就是能够拿到1亿马币。
Okay, how many of you want that? ₱1 billion, you know, don't play, you know.
有谁要呢？
And then the second one, very plain. It's nothing but to live the Christian life. That's it. Very plain.
然后另外一个呢，一个按钮呢是很简单，什么都没有的，就是我要做一名基督徒。
Which one do you want?
你如果自己再按两个按钮，你会按哪一个按钮？
Most of us tempted to, you know, we're tempted, right? That ₱1 billion is like, whoa, I want it.
如果是我们呢，大部分的我们呢，都会很就是想要的去按那个一亿的那个按钮。
It's just like God, you know, stay in heaven, that comfortable life, divine, you have everything you want, or go down to earth and suffer.Be a man and suffer, and even suffer to the point of death, and death on the cross.
我相信这种决定呢，就很像天上的神要决定下来活在我们当中，甚至死在十字架上的那种选择一样的难。
You know, if you're God, what will you choose? The comfortable life, the divine life, you have everything, or suffering as a human being to the point of death.
那你会怎么选呢？你会选说去选择活在我们当中，甚至是愿意成为人类去面对所有的痛苦吗
？So why would God become a man？
那为什么那么难，神还是要选择
？I don't really know why。
我不是那么的肯定。
Okay, because Isaiah says God's ways is not our ways.
就像经文里面说，他说神的意念呢，并不是我们人的意念。
Right, let's read chapter 55, verse 8 to 9.
我们读以赛亚书第55章第8到第9节，耶和华神说：“我的意念不是你们的意念，你们的道路也不是我的道路。天怎样高过地，我的道路也怎样高过你们的道路。我的意念。”也怎样高过你们的意念
？Okay, why he became a man? I really don't know. But his ways are not our ways.
那他为什么要活在我们当中？实际我不知道。因为神的意念呢，并不是我的意念。
But his ways, even though we don't understand, is higher Okay, as high as the heavens above. It's way higher, way better than our ways.
但是呢，他的方法，他的道路呢，虽然不是我们的道路，可是呢，他的方法却是高过我们的方法，高过我们的道路。
So, because his ways, even though we don't understand, is way higher than our ways, we must learn to trust his ways.
既然如此，神的方法比我们更好，那我们更应该去选择去他的道路。
So let's read Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6.
我们读箴言第三章第五到第六节。第五节，你要一心依赖耶和华，不可依赖自己的聪明，在你一切所行的道路上都要承认他，他必使你的路径平坦正直。
And when you trust his ways, all of a sudden, God make your path straight.
那圣经说，他说我们如果一心的依赖神的话呢，他说神会使我们的道路平坦正直。
You know your life, your life gets so much more better, so much more smoother, and you're so much more joyful in the midst of all kind of trouble.
换句话说，他就好像说，生命里面，因着我们的依靠，依赖神呢。我们的生命里面虽然面对很多的挑战问题，但是在当中呢，我们还是可以平坦的，可以无畏的，可以平安的去面对。
You know, and many times we don't even notice that Jesus actually is walking with us and helping us.
很多时候呢，我们甚至没有感觉得到他其实在跟我们同行。
Okay, another one of the campus brothers, he shared this.
那这也是其中的一个就是弟兄在我们刚才的其中一个弟兄，他分享这个看法。
He says in Book of Luke chapter 24, Jesus was going down the road to Emmaus.
那么就讲到说他这个耶稣呢，他走在路上啊 ，Emmaus.
Okay, and even though he's walking down the path, the two disciples saw him, but they didn't even know and recognize him.
就是他复活过后，他走在那路上，然后两个他自己的门徒认不出他。
Interesting, these are guys that spent three years with him, and they didn't even recognize him.
因为呢，这很奇怪的是说，这些门徒已经跟随耶稣三年了，竟然耶稣复活过后他认不出他。
But the point that the brother made was that you know sometimes Jesus is walking next to us, helping us, you know.We are not even aware. Okay, we don't even recognize that he actually is helping us.
在我们生命其实很多时候是这样的。耶稣明明在我们身旁在帮助我们，我们呢却没有办法察觉得到他在帮我们。
Okay, we need to be more aware and more grateful and, you know, and recognize that and call out to Jesus.
那我们呢？其实应该学习去体会到、感受到耶稣呢，他正在我们身边帮着我们。
So, key point, very important. Don't be proud. Okay, don't think my way is the right way. You know, end up, the Bible says what? End up, it might enter lead to death.
所以呢，重点的学习是在生命里面不要骄傲，不要因为骄傲而迷失了自己。
All right. So, these are some possible reasons from my own mind. Some possible reason why Jesus came.
我自己得出了一些结论为什么耶稣会化为人。
All right. Number one, so that we can believe.
第一就是我们可以使到我们可以相信。
You know, human beings, we have this statement, right? Seeing is believing. We need to see.So Jesus came so that you can see.
是的，我们的人呢，我们有一种行为，就是我们需要看得见才可以相信的。
Okay, when you see, you get to understand God, His character, like the seven I am's. You get to understand His character better, and see His power.
因为呢，我们呢可以用眼睛来看到 当耶稣他自称他是谁的时候，我们眼睛看到也能够深入的更加懂得去体会得到。
Okay, so you're not following an invisible God that you hardly know. You're following a God that you can know.
那你不是像我们一般说去相信，盲目的相信一个眼睛又看不到的神，不是，而反而是你看的一个可以看得见、可以做榜样的一位神。
And He came down to show you that He cares.
他来从天上来到我们当中，来去表达他关心我们。
Why else would he spend time with 12 rough, I don't know, are they smelly? Maybe they are, you know.
Fishermen,
you know. How many of you love the smell of fish? I love to eat fish, but we sometimes, wow, very, huh?
是的, you know, 你就想一下, 也天上的神, 降为人, 过后呢, 愿意跟着十二个门徒, 我也不懂他们到底是一个怎么样的人。但是都渔夫嘛，味道肯定是有的了啊。但是为什么他愿意呢
？You know, but he was willing to hang out, have fun, cook together, eat together, climb mountain together. You know, it shows God wants to have that relationship with you. God wants to love you and care for you, and He wants to spend time with you. You are precious and important to Him.
那你可以看见他的故事里面提到，当耶稣跟他的门徒在一起的时候，如何度过那些美好的时光，一起煮，一起去打鱼，一起去教导，一起去祷告等等，他的那种生命里面显露出神是多么的渴望和关心跟他们跟他们在一起。
Okay, and another reason why he came down as a man is that what? He wants to show us that you can overcome. He overcame.You can overcome.
当然另外一个原因是他想要证明给我们看，我们是有这个能力去克服。
No matter what struggle, what difficulty you go through, he will be there to help you.
然后呢，不管在生命里面，我们正在面对什么样的挑战和困难，神呢，耶稣呢，他会在那里，然后他会跟着我们一起帮我们克服。
You know, I don't know if Apostle John was married. He probably was.
我不知道约翰有结婚吗？可能有。
Okay, you know, I wonder with John's temper, how did his wife feel? You know, he probably feel like, man, this guy's husband of thunder. I wish he would just quiet down.Hard to live with, you know.
如果真的是有结婚，他的太太不懂怎么想，他的丈夫呢，一个被称为雷霆之子、刚烈的性格，你怎样形容一位这样子的伴侣呢
？All right, how many of you like to live with a man or woman, you know, known as son or woman of thunder? It's like, oh, no peace.
那你是想象你的伴侣如果是这样的人的话呢？你想象你要跟他生活在一起？绝对是非常困难的。
But you know, John overcame. His character changed because he decided to let God change his life. He decided to follow Jesus and let Jesus transform him.
但是呢，你看看，约翰他的生命改变了，他改变的性格，然后呢，为什么呢？是因为主耶稣基督感动了他的生命。
Okay, and then Jesus came as a man to show you the model of good living. What's a good life?
所以呢，耶稣他来到我们当中，给了我们活生生的一个例子和一个榜样。
Okay, a good life doesn't have to happen. What you call? Most of us, we think a good life must be what? Must include a lot of money, a lot of power. If we don't have power, we don't have money, habis lah.
我们很多人，我们都是这么想的。我们说，生命里面需要有很多的钱、很多的权利这样我们才会感觉到安心。
Okay, and of course, those things are good if you can have it, but that does not give you the good life. You see, many rich people, they have very sad life, unhappy, end up in divorce, sleeping in husband and wife sleeping in two different bedroom.
是的，但是呢，我们却发现事实不是那样的。 很多的有这些金钱和权力的人，他们的生命是非常的糟糕的。我们有目共睹，在很多的新闻报道里面都看得见啊，不，事实并不是这样。
You know, but you look at Jesus, right? He wasn't rich, born in a manger, poor guy, lived very ordinary, but his life was filled with joy, joy and laughter.
可是呢，你看看，耶稣他并不是生在一个富裕的家庭，可是在他生命里面有的是什么？他有的是内心里面种种的喜乐啊，平安的生命啊，这些都是。
And of course, he came down as a man to show you that we can be saved. Our sins can be forgiven, and there is heaven because there is resurrection. Amen.
当然呢，最重要的是他证明了给我们一样事情，就是我们可以克服我们生命中的挣扎，我们的罪。他甚至告诉我们说，我们可以。胜利胜过我们的挣扎。
So as you ponder, all right, about the incarnation of the Son of God, Jesus, the incarnation of the Son of God, what is your response? What's your conviction?
那今天呢、啊，来我们自己来想一想，我们想到耶稣成为肉身在我们的自己的生命里面，又有些起些什么的作用，什么的影响呢？
So following Jesus is not just mentally. Oh, I believe.
因为呢，跟随耶稣呢，不是你的思想上和说啊，我跟随耶稣啊罢了那么简单。
Okay, oh, he's some savior up there. You know, mentally we believe, but emotionally, okay, we are not really there. Conviction, we are not really there.
我们并不是单单说只是。在脑子里面、思想里面说我们相信，可是呢，在我们内心里面的那个信念，我们自己的信心呢是空洞的，是没有的。
Okay, and that's what happened to Nicodemus in John chapter 3.
这就是在约翰福音里面提到的那个尼格底姆。
He believed, but he did not want to commit.
那尼哥底母是一位老师，他相信，可是呢，他却不想投入。
You know, so you know what? Because he believed, he wanted to see Jesus.
那他因着他相信，他就想要去见耶稣。
But because he was afraid of criticism from other people, and he wasn't willing to fully commit, he came in the night.
那也因着他只相信，但是他没有信念的，他又怕别人讲他哦。他只好偷偷的在晚上半夜的时候才去找耶稣。
And then when Jesus started to teach him, simple teaching actually, man must be born again, but he found it so hard to accept.
而耶稣呢，他只是很简单的跟他分享和教导他关于到人必须要重生，而他尼格底母呢听了过后，他觉得很错愕，很难接受一个很简单的教导。
So Jesus at the very end shared this passage to him, John chapter 3, verse 19 to 21.
然后呢，之后呢，就是耶稣就跟他这样分享，在19节到21节，光来到世上是人呢，因为自己的行为邪恶，不爱光，倒爱黑暗，定他们罪的原因就在这里。凡作恶的都恨光，不来接近光，免得他的恶行。暴露出来，凡行真理的就来接近光，好显明他所做的都是靠着神而做的。
You know, when you encounter Jesus, when anybody encounter Jesus, there's usually two responses.
因为呢，只要一般人接触耶稣呢，都会做出反应。
All right, you could either be drawn to Jesus.
那个反应是说，你可能会很受到他吸引。
Like the early disciples, you know, when they heard, oh, look, the Lamb of God, they chase after Jesus. Jesus, where are you staying? And they spend the whole day with Jesus to learn from him.
那就很像早期的那些门徒们看见耶稣的时候，他哇，耶稣啊，他们很热心，很热心的去追随着耶稣。
Okay, and then they were so excited after spending time with Jesus, they went on to share, right, excitedly to their friends and family.
他们非常热诚的去跟随耶稣，也凭着他们的信念呢，他们之后也去继续的跟别人分享关于到耶稣。
Okay, or the other response is what we hide from the truth, because Jesus is the light. It is hard to be in the light when you are not willing to fully accept the light.
那另外一种反应呢是，你会选择隐藏，在黑暗里面，你不想要面对那个光，因为黑暗是不能接受光的。
Right, it's just like that story that I just shared about Nicodemus.
那就好像刚才我们听到尼克迪姆的那个故事一样。
You know, I like the truth, but I don't want to be seen in the truth.
那就好像尼克迪姆的那种态度是，我相信耶稣，但是我却不要在。不要让我看，不要看见我不要在光里面。
Okay, so your life is not evident, you know, as a disciple of Jesus.
那你换句话说，你的生命呢？在一名门徒的生命里面呢，是不明显的。
But the good news is, when you do accept, when you do believe, something happens.
那事实是这样的哈，就是如果你相信的话呢，你的生命将会是。
Okay, so let's read John chapter 1, verse 12 to 13. We'll end with this passage.
Okay, 我们来读约翰福音第一章第十二到十三节。十二节，凡接受他的，就是信他名的人，他就赐给他们权力成为神的儿女。他们不是从血统生的，不是从肉身的意识生的，也不是从人意生的，而是从神生的。
When you believe, okay, really believe in Jesus, something happened.
那你如果生命里面真的有信心的相信耶稣的话呢，你的生命里面会改变。
God give you the right. Yeah, the right. It's not you know, but not anybody can get it.It's up to God's authority. He gives you the right to become His child.
那神呢？他会赐给我们，也就只有神才做得到的哦。就是他的权力上，他告诉他说我们可以，他给我们这个权力，说当他的当神的儿女。
Okay, as I shared last year in one of some of my sermon, you get a new ID, new ID in Christ.
就好像我们呢，在去年我的传道里面也跟大家分享过我们新的身份。
You have a new passport.
我们有一个新的护照或者是新的 IC.
Okay, passport, a new passport. And this passport allows you to go to heaven. You don't have, sorry.
是的，这本护照不得了，可以去天国的护照。
And while living on earth, you are a new creation.
然后呢，你在世上呢，你却是一个新造的人。
That means, you know, new creation, that means you can start fresh.
新造人的意思呢，是说我们呢，可以随时随地从新开始。
You can start new.
你每一天都能够从新的一面开始。
And every day, you can be renewed.
然后每一天呢，你的内心呢，都可以翻新。
And every day, the past is gone, and the new is here.
然后每一天呢，你都可以过一种你的以往已经过去了，你可以现在面对你的心。
And that I say, brothers and sisters, that's good news. You can be a new creation every single day because of Christ. Amen.
那对我来说呢，弟兄姐妹，那就是一种好消息。为什么呢？因为我们每一天，我们的生命。不管我们以前做错什么，我们都可以重新开始。
Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Uh, brother and sister, let's bow down our head for communion prayer. Heavenly God Father, as we came before you today with our grateful hearts, we thank you for your sacrifice of your Son Jesus Christ and the love that you have shown to us, God. As we partake the communion today, as the wine represents your blood and the bread represents your flesh, we ask for your help to remember the sacrifice that Jesus made on behalf, due to our sins, God. We ask for your forgiveness for any wrongdoings that we have committed and for the strength to turn away from the sins and to follow you more closely, God. We ask for your continued guidance and wisdom as we seek the lives and the lives that we that are more pleasing to you, God. Help us to be your hands and feet in the world, God, showing love and compassion to those that are around us. We pray for those who are hurting and struggling today. We ask for your comfort and healing to be with them. And we ask for you to provide for their needs, God. As we close this prayer with with full of hearts, with gratitude and grace and mercy, thank you for your love, God. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen.
Amen. Let's take a moment, meditate on Jesus' love while we're holding the cup. 让我们花点时间握着这个杯来思想主耶稣对我们的爱。 Let's partake the bread and wine together. 让我们一起用这个圣餐。 Okay, now it's the time for us to pass the poor contribution back. The fund collected will be used in helping the needy in Johor Bahru area. 接下来呢，我们将传爱心奉献袋，所收集到的款项将被用于帮助新山地区有需要的人士。
在尽头，你将会发现主已为你我而预备。面向太阳，它总不改变，虽然笑雨洒在脸上。面向太阳，它总不改变。
We got short announcement. Okay, my name is Leo. Okay, the June schedule. 这个是六月份的时间表。Okay, today at the church we got Team Fun Revival. Okay, five p.m. to 6 p.m. Okay, 接下来教会过后，我们有一个青少年的欢乐灵修灵修会是5点钟到6点钟，请青少年留下来。OK， June level you can take a picture 你们可以不记得可以放照相。OK， 接下来是我们的 special event。这是我们的特别的聚会 ，OK， 16 June， 8 p.m. we got， sorry 8 a.m. 早上 ，OK， church family day， we got outdoor service， OK， 接下来的是我们的特别聚会，6月16号，是我们的户外的崇拜家庭日 ，OK， 接下来就是我们的接下来就是我们的灵修退休会是在9月份的14号到16号 ，OK， September 40 to 60 is we church retreat。Okay, it's Malacca. Okay, 谢谢大家。我们的聚会已经完毕，希望大家有个美好的聚会跟很好的交流。Have a good time and fellowship. Thank you.